once everyone quiets down, I can start, I guess.
Okay.
Welcome. Welcome, honored guests, parents, teachers, and students. Welcome, one and all, to this year's opening assembly for the 2017 International Festival at the American School of The Hague.
We are delighted to have so many of you in the sport hall today. Before we get things started, just a quick safety note. In the unlikely event of an emergency, please exit through the three doors that lead into the courtyard.
We've got a fantabulous program for you today.
With the flag parade, the magnificent acts from all around the world, and your very own crafty MCs. We're sure you'll enjoy it.
To kick off the assembly, we'd like to celebrate becoming a fair trade school. Here at ASH, we now use products that give farmers and growers a fair price and fair working conditions.
Here we have the ASH Fair Trade Committee showing off our latest flag. We are honored to welcome the former mayor of Wassenaar, Mr. Jan Hoekema, and the alderman of Wassenaar, Mr. Leo Maat. Mr. Peter Arts from the Stichting Fair Trade Gemeente, along with Mrs. Hedwig Smits and Mr. Bob Berger from Fair Trade Wassenaar. Here to present the Fair Trade School title, we have the executive director of Stichting Max Havelaar, Mr. Peter Dangremont.
Please welcome to the stage Dr. Spradling and Mr. Dangremont.
Good morning. It's a big privilege and honor to be here with so many kids and so many parents and staff and board of the school and a lot of other people around it. And it's especially great as a director of fair trade in the Netherlands to see that this school did so much to become a fair trade school. It was initiated by the board facilitated the staff, and the staff inspired all the pupils of the school. Great, great work. Whenever you look at such a performance, it's always difficult to thank a few people especially, because it's really a big team effort. Nevertheless, I would like to thank especially Helen Ford, Rebecca Paul, and Carol Nealand. Please give them a big applause for the work they did. It's not only coffee and tea, which are among the biggest products Fairtrade certified that are being used now here at this school, but it's also what I read in the report that the jury wrote. It's also sugar, honey, and what I heard, the little Tony Chocolonies. Well, those must be great. I think you'll love them. What I also read in the report of the jury is that this school did especially well on communicating about fair trade, using new media, using old media, and that is something that really caught the eye of the jury. So a big compliment for that, and also a challenge to you all to further roll out this fantastic communication around fair trade. Now, before I go over to handing out the official Fairtrade plaquette, I would like to refer a little bit to Fairtrade. And when I look around here in this school, I see future teachers, I see future engineers, I see future doctors, builders, and perhaps even a future president of your country. You all may enjoy a day off when classes are not there or when you have a vacation. But you're also very privileged, because in many countries, especially in the developing world where we as Fairtrade work, kids are not as privileged as you are to go to school because their parents don't have enough money. They can't pay for the school. The governments haven't facilitated that. And that is perhaps the heart of what Fairtrade is doing. Fairtrade is trying to create opportunities for people with talents by offering them fair prices for their products. That's the essence of Fairtrade. So enjoy your education here and be proud of what you do all together for kids in a developing world. That's a big compliment for you all. That's, I think, also a nice bridge to actually formalizing the Fairtrade School Award. And Dr. Spreadling, I would like to hand this over to you as director of the school. And a very big compliment and congratulations.
Thank you. We're very excited about receiving this certification. I believe we are the first school in Vassanar to receive fair trade certification. Well done, Ash. Well done. We think that being a fair trade school ties into today's theme of unity through diversity. The concept of fair trade is that we cannot be successful individually. Only if we connect with people from around the world doing all the different things that they do we become a successful and global world. So we're happy to be reaching out beyond Vassanar, beyond our school, to be a part of the larger unified theme of diversity, people working in countries all over the world and all sorts of cultures, all sorts of languages, together interacting with their commerce. And we're happy to be a part of that. We think that does tie into today's theme, unity through diversity. Ash is a very special place. Over 40 languages spoken here, something like 80 different nationalities. And we're proud of that. And today we'll celebrate our diversity, but also we come together as one today. And when you watch the parade of flags, each person should be very justifiably proud of their individual country. But what we've learned is, we cannot be successful, we cannot reach the ASH values, we cannot achieve our mission and our vision by ourselves or with any one group, whether it's a class, a nationality, or a culture. Only if we are all together do we achieve our mission and do we live up to our school's core values. So today, actually, when you see something as simple and obvious as when we sing Tell Me together, that's all of us actually unifying our voices, our diverse voices, into one powerful voice. And that's today's theme of what we want to do. We do want to thank a few people, a lot of folks, a lot of student volunteers, CAS people, parent volunteers, staff volunteers, and I want to particularly single out the fellow in charge of the whole thing, Steve Erickson. Congratulations to Steve. And where are you there, my boy? Take a quick little bow. We've come up with a whole different format this year with Steve, and so I want to make sure and encourage everybody to come back tomorrow for the second half of what goes on. We'll have much more in the way of international food, celebrations, entertainment. Be sure you're with us back tomorrow also. Now, again, I want to say thank you and a big welcome to our special guests. We have people here from the embassies of Australia and Canada. We have Patrick Chow from the U.S. Embassy. We have Mayor Hokema. People from the Fair Trade and Max Havelaar foundations, and we're proud of being as an entity in Vassanar that celebrates enormous diversity, but the power of merging diversity into unity in one voice. So thank you very much, and good luck, and have a wonderful International Day 2017, and congratulations, Fair Trade.
Thank you for those warm words. I'm glad Ash has joined the fair trade community.
Me too. It's a beautiful thing to add to the Ash culture.
It's amazing how diverse and international this school is.
You're right. Dutch.
I'm also a senior coming from the United States. My name is Molly, and Arjun and I are your high school MCs this morning.
You know, Molly, including our own, I believe that we have 76 nationalities represented here today.
That's incredible. And here we are, united together for a day of community and diversity. After all, this year's theme is unity through diversity.
In fact, we have 79 flags and flag bearers behind us that are ready to bring on one of my favorite parts of the assembly, the flag parade. Representing 76 nationalities, most of the flag bearers are seniors carrying the flags one last time before graduating. Leading off, we have, next to the fair trade flag, our own school flag and the eco flag. Then we have... the ash flag. The eco flag. Argentina. Australia, Austria, Barbados, Belarus, Belgium, Bolivia, Brazil, Brunei, Bulgaria, Burkina Faso, Cameroon, and Canada.
Costa Rica, Czech Republic, and on one crutch, Denmark, Ecuador, Egypt, Ethiopia, Finland, France, and Georgia.
Germany. Ghana. Greece. Guatemala. Hong Kong. Hungary. Japan, Kazakhstan, Kenya, Kuwait, Latvia, Libya, Lithuania, Luxembourg, Slovakia, South Africa. Switzerland, Taiwan, Thailand, Turkey, Ukraine, new this year. Okay. United Kingdom, Venezuela, the United States of America, the Netherlands,
let's hear it everyone for this year's country flag parade.
With students, staff, and parents from all over the world, we live in a culturally rich place. You're right. My name is Mary Kate.
And my name is Connor.
And we're from the U.S. We're your middle school MCs today. I'm in 7th grade, and Connor's in 5th grade. Here's a huge secret. He's my brother.
Hey, I can speak for myself. I think I'll introduce the first act. We are pleased to introduce the U.S. Embassy Deputy Chief of Mission, Mr. Patrick Chow. He's here to say a few words this morning.
Please put your hands together to welcome him.
This is a big crowd. Good morning, everyone. I would like to thank the ASH community and ASH students for the invitation today to speak at today's International Day Assembly. Our daughter attends this school, and it gives me great pleasure to talk about why I think learning in a multicultural and diverse environment can be advantageous in life. I was born in the United States, and having parents who came from China, they wanted me to have a different childhood experience than most American students. At the age of 5, they moved our family to Taiwan, where I was enrolled in a local Chinese school. Now, I had no understanding of Chinese, so this experience was quite a shock to me. However, as the school year went on, I began to learn Chinese and understand the culture. And after that year was finished, I was completely fluent in Chinese. Only problem was, I forgot all my English. Upon returning to America, I had to learn it all over again. At age 6, this was quite a challenge. But going through this process has given me a gift for which I am forever grateful. I am now very interested in understanding different cultures, really appreciate another person's perspective, and enjoy the company of those who see the world differently from me. Why is this important? Well, we are all different people on this earth, and we should appreciate those differences. This diversity, that's what makes us all special. Getting exposed to a different culture during your school years gives you a chance to begin to understand another culture. From there, it opens your eyes to a whole world of possibilities. For me, without knowing it, my childhood experience with different cultures, living in different places, continues to this day. It is wonderful to have this opportunity to understand why someone thinks a certain way about something while others think another way. This is what makes life interesting. What would the world be like if we all liked the same flavor of ice cream, the same color, or the same clothes? How interesting would life be? What kind of world would that be? Most important, what kind of person would you be? Diversity is what makes the world go round and helps us appreciate life, which is full of surprises. What I love about ASH is that it is an international school that provides an environment for students from various cultures to interact with one another in the classroom, on the playground, or in extracurricular activities. These are chances to broaden your mind, open yourself to new experiences, and most important, give you a new perspective. Embrace this opportunity, make friends with those who come from different countries and different cultures. This is what it's all about, being international, multicultural, and diverse. I promise you, if you are, you will definitely have an interesting life. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chow. You have brought such wonderful meaning to our festival's theme. Unity through diversity is something that the Netherlands and United States have in common.
For another piece of diversity in music and dance, we have up next an Israeli performance brought to you by my fellow senior, Noga Arad, and 13 other dancers, taking the stage away with Sil Sulim by Static and Ben El Tavori.
המקום הכי חם במזרח התיכון מדינה קטנה, סתכלו סביב יש ביג בלאגן בתל אביב חולים על מעוולים ועפים איך שהביט נכנס הקצב של הבסים יעשה לך בראש קרקס ועד מתי באמצע המדבר לא צריך עוד שום דבר אז אני שם אין לנו אז אם אתה מרגיש שחד תתארגן על אותו ועל בגד לך
silsulin.
Thank you, Israeli performers. Now that we've had a couple fantastic performances and we've heard from the United States Embassy Deputy Chief of Mission, Mr. Patrick Chow, let's please welcome Australian Embassy Charge d'Affaires, Ms. Indra McCormick, to the stage.
Good morning. Great dancing. Thanks. Dr. Spradling, ASH community, students, honoured guests, it's really an honour to be here today. In addition to my job at the Australian Embassy, I should just say a chargé d'affaires is essentially someone who's standing in for the ambassador when the ambassador is out of the country. So in my normal job is Deputy Australian Ambassador. But I'm also a mother of three children at this fantastic school. So if I hear any groaning or yawning, I think I'll know where it's coming from. So unity through diversity. It's a great theme for a diverse international school like ASH. When I started to think about what I should say today, I asked my grade five student what she thought unity through diversity meant. And she said, and I quote, "Oh, you know, Mum, it's when people who are different work together to create a better world. Anyway, that's what they always say on those TV shows for little kids, like the Care Bears." I found her. Anyway, the Care Bears is obviously a better show than I've ever given it credit for, because that's a pretty good interpretation. But I'm confident that I can speak with a little bit more authority than the Care Bears about diversity in Australia. So I'm just going to tell you a little bit about Australia. So I grew up in Australia, and like Patrick, I come from a diverse cultural background. My mother was raised in a village by a muddy river on the island of Java in Indonesia, where her family ran a dairy. And as a kid, she helped milk the cows, she travelled in a horse-drawn cart to a small local school. And when she was about 12 or 13, her family sent her away to a bigger school where she had to board with a family that she didn't know. Now, that was a time in Indonesia's history where there was a great deal of political conflict, and it was actually very dangerous to be there. And in the neighbouring country of Australia, my father, whose parents have a Scottish and Irish heritage, grew up in a very different way. Australia was a peaceful and wealthy place compared to Indonesia. This was in the 1960s. And Dad tells us he spent most of his childhood playing sport, mainly cricket, in the Australian summers. My parents met at university in Sydney, where my mother was a foreign student. And when they married, it was pretty unusual. In the 1960s, marriage between people of different ethnicities was not that common in Australia nor Indonesia.
So I have memories of growing up as someone who did everything that other Aussie kids did. You know, like riding kangaroos and wrestling with sharks and crocodiles. All right, I'm only kidding. You can't really ride kangaroos. Actually, that was my husband's bad dad joke. These days, but I also had one foot in a different culture, and that was Indonesia, where there wasn't so many opportunities for sport and outdoor leisure, and where people lived in close quarters and often in extended families with their cousins, their aunts and uncles, and their grandparents. These days, many in Australia, like here, have similarly diverse cultural histories. One in four Australians was born overseas, and one out of every two Australians have at least one parent who was born overseas. For many decades, lots of people from around the world have moved to Australia to live, and we continue to take around 200,000 new migrants each year, which is quite a big number for our population. In the past, it was mainly people from Britain and from other parts of Europe who moved to Australia. But these days, it's mainly people from India and China and other parts of Asia. When I visit the suburb that I grew up in today, it's almost unrecognisable. If you walk down the main shopping street, you could be in a bustling suburb of Hong Kong or Seoul or Hanoi or Jakarta. I was not at all surprised at the extravaganza last week to see your very own Mr. Townsend from Australia play and teach the Gamelan Orchestra. Another really important aspect of our diversity in Australia, not just our migrant heritage, but our Indigenous population, Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people. Now, Europe has often been described as the old world, and countries like Australia and America as the new world. And that's the way it was taught when I was at school, just because the history that we learnt was seen through the eyes of Europeans. But it's little known and little appreciated, even in Australia, that Australia is home to the oldest continuous living culture in the world, one that goes back more than 50,000 years, and that's before the earliest known cave paintings in Europe. And in my lifetime, just in the last couple of decades, it's been really interesting to see how much more effort is being put into preserving what's left of our cult, this ancient heritage. And Australians are increasingly appreciating that Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander culture is something that's unique, that's fascinating, and that's inherently valuable, and is a culture that we can learn a lot from today. Now, modern Australia, like the Netherlands, is an outward-facing country. And that means we believe that peace between countries and economic prosperity for everyone depends on us and other countries engaging as much as possible with the rest of the world. And we do this through diplomacy, through our business connections and trade, through sport, through education, through the arts and culture, pretty much every facet of life. And we think that the way that we live now, our mixed up culture with everything from cricket to gamelan orchestras, has benefited enormously from this openness to the world. But as Dr. Spradling mentioned earlier, it needs to be recognised that having a lot of diversity isn't automatically an advantage. We need people to pull together, have shared objectives, and agree on a few important things. In Australia, it's things like our democratic values, the importance of obeying the law, respect, so on. In a diverse society and a diverse community like this school, that level of consensus isn't always easy to arrange. And unifying diverse societies is one of the most important and difficult jobs that governments everywhere face. And it's also a challenge for every large group of people, from businesses to communities and even to schools. And leadership needs to deal with that and make efforts to unify in order to succeed or even to survive. This is a school that does that to an exceptional extent. Every event that I go to, extravaganza, today's event, every interaction that my kids have at school, all the reports that I get back from the classroom, it's really evident that the amount of work that the school puts into developing this unified vision, mission, and a sense of unified purpose is very successful. So, happy International Day, Ash, and thank you very much for listening.
Wonderful words, Miss McCormick. We are so honored you could speak here today. My name is Lauriane Desmia. I'm in fourth grade and I came from France.
My name is Leo Bogdanaris. I'm also in fourth grade and I'm from Canada. We are lucky enough to be your elementary school MCs. So what's up next, Lauriane?
Well, first you're gonna have to show the audience your own dance. Something rhythmic.
What?
Just clap your hands, stomp your feet, drum on your thighs, that kind of thing, Leo. I thought you said you could do this. I can't look. Luckily, we have a group of drummers from South Korea here to show you what real rhythm looks like.
Please welcome our very own 14 Korean drummers performing the song Arirang on three different percussion instruments. Geez, I couldn't even do simple body rhythms.
When this word is spoken, comes the courage that can't be broken. Stand by me for this unification.
makes sense.
Wow, that was awesome.
I'm still reeling. Wonderfully performed, Korea. Okay, Arjun, get excited because up next we have a mambo.
Seriously, what kind? There's Cuban and Spanish and, well, if I'm going to be entirely correct, it's Afro-Cuban.
Hold your horses. How do you know all of that?
Hey, I'm just following the script. Anyways, where does this type of mambo come from?
Italy. Our next act is an Italian dance group of 6 children performing to the song Italian Mambo. Please welcome them to the stage.
A boy went back to Napoli because he missed the scenery, the native dancers and the charming songs. But wait a minute, something's wrong. Do the mambo like crazy and hey mambo, don't want a tarantella, hey mambo, no more a mozzarella, hey mambo, Italiano, try an enchilada with a fish and baccalade, and hey gumba, I love how you dance, rumba, but take some advice, my son, learn how to mambo, if you're gonna be a square, you're ever gonna go nowhere, hey mambo, mambo, Italiano, hey mambo, Italiano, go, go, Joe, shake like a Giovanni, hello, quesadilla, get a happy in the pizza when you're mambo.
Connor, I just love the mambo. So much energy.
What a fantastic performance. But I think we have another energetic act right after this.
Exciting. Where are they from?
Well, Mary Kate, their mystical, energetic, wondrous song has been described as the craziest freestyle of Bollywood's 2016 to 2017 season. Dun, dun, dun.
Really? What is it called?
Lagki Beautiful, Kar Gai Chul.
Fantastic! Everyone, let's give our Indian dancers a hand and welcome them on.
Beautiful kar gayi chul beautiful kar gayi chul
India. We've enjoyed your crazy percussion dancing galore, and now it's time to move on to some good old-fashioned Legacy Elite Gymnastics and cheer. Legacy Elite Gymnastics is a cheerleading and gymnastics club based in Wassenaar with members from various international and Dutch schools.
All athletes are from diverse backgrounds, and through focusing not on our differences but on our shared goals and values, our athletes work together to form lasting friendships and even win national titles. How exciting. Hey, I can cheer. I think that's the only requirement. Maybe I can join.
Oh, Lorianne, it's much more than that. You can cheer them on from the sidelines.
Okay. In any case, let's all cheer on the 36 Ash students from the gymnastic and cheer team.
and I ain't nobody else. Feeling feelings I never felt. The way you got me under your spell. Don't you keep it out to yourself. So won't you tell. And I ain't nobody else.
everyone. We are so grateful to our honored guests, parents, teachers, and students that you made it today.
Thank you to all those involved in making these assembly and the rest of the festival's celebrations possible.
Through all the diversity in our background, ethnicity, and traditions, you name it, we have united here to celebrate our differences and come together as a community.
From my land to your land,
my tongue to your tongue,
and my culture to your culture,
Happy International Festival.
Please enjoy the rest of the festival tomorrow with great food, games, performances, one-of-a-kind country basket raffle, and so much more. It will run from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m.